This is BBC One. And now our Wednesday matinee with Hugh Burden and John Moffat in A.G. MacDonald's account of the cricket match.
No one need be afraid that this is going to be another war film. After this first sequence, there will be no terrifying descriptions of the effect of a chlorine gas cloud on a party of nuns in a bombarded manor. No long subjective accounts of the visions of a man during the last few split seconds of his life. No profound moralizings on the inscrutability of a divine omnipotence which creates the rose and the bayonet. In a word, after this there will be, to borrow the name of an ardent society of left-wing pacifists in the 30s, no more war. Nevertheless, the events which follow had their real origin in a conversation which took place between two artillerymen on the Western Front in the beginning of October 1917.
Oh, I don't know. We at the Ringley Subaltern once in our battle used to run out and extinguish fires in ammunition dumps.
You know what?
Put out fires in shell dumps.
Whatever for?
Well, they said that shells cost £5 each and it was everyone's duty to save government money.
And where's he buried?
The little cemetery at the back of Blumertown.
I know it. Why do the English always laugh when Aberdeen is mentioned?
Heaven knows. Why do they have a Welsh Prime Minister and a Scotch commander?
Scotch.
Oh, sorry. A Scottish Commander-in-Chief and a Scottish First Sea Lord of the Admiralty and think it's funny.
But why do the English always pretend that...
Oh, for heaven's sake, this is a private man. Here, have a drop of Scotch. Oh, I beg your pardon. A drop of Scotch or Scottish. Well, I'm a publisher by profession. The more I see of the Englishman as a businessman or a literary man, the more bewildered I become.
I think they're rather fascinating.
Oh, they're fascinating, all right. I don't understand them. Hell, now we're off.
The wires are down. One of you have to run for it.
Oh, that's frightening. But it's possible. All right, you call. Bloody hell.
I'd like to write a book about them someday.
It's a book with one striking. You look me up when this bloody war's over, and we'll discuss it.
¶¶